So there are three particular techniques you can use to get a large language model solve very complex tasks. So let me start with the easiest one, which is called in-context learning. The team that trained GPT-3 found something they were not expecting. So when they trained the model, they realized that by providing a few examples, they could condition the output of the model. If you look at this example here, you'll see how I'm telling the model how I want the answer by showing it three different examples of how it should behave. Another way of using in-context learning is by something we call grounding the model. This is very simple. You basically give the model all of the knowledge it needs to answer a particular question. So imagine you wrote a book and you want to build an application capable of answering questions about the book. By default, the model doesn't know anything about the book. So you can include as part of your prompt the text of the book and force the model to always answer questions from that text. Now, this is great unless your book is very long, because these models have a limit on how large the prompt can be. We call that the context length. And for example, GPT-4, there is a version of it that supports about 6,000 words in the context. There is another version that supports about 25,000 words. And it sounds like a lot, but when you're building a real application, that context might not be enough. When that happens, you need to use the second technique, which is called indexing. Here, you are gonna use a vector database, which is a special database that can store vectors or list of numbers. So the way you use this is as follows. You can take your book and break it down into different passages, and then you can generate an embedding from each one of those passages. An embedding is nothing else than a vector. It's just an array full of numbers that represent or encode the text of the particular passage. When you do this, you can store all of those embeddings in the vector database. And here is what's cool about these databases. They will let you search for any embedding really quickly. So you can take the question you want to ask the model and generate an embedding for it. And using that embedding, you can search the vector database for the list of passages that are the most similar to the question you asked. You can use those passages then to provide enough context to the model to answer the query. And that way you will be bypassing the context length because you don't need to provide the entire book. There is a third technique that you can use when in-context learning or indexing are not enough, and that's fine-tuning. The whole idea is to get your own data and teach the model how to solve a specific task using that data. One way of doing this is by processing the data you have using the large language model, generating outputs, and then using those outputs to train a separate model, a separate classifier that's going to be in charge of solving your particular task. This is probably the easiest way of fine-tuning because you're actually not touching the original model, which is, it takes a long time to do. You require special hardware, and it will probably cost you a lot of money. The second way is to rewire that large language model. And here you are changing the value of the parameters of that model to solve your specific task. Now, depending on how much you fine-tune that model, how many layers you actually change, it's how much you're gonna pay or how much you're gonna have to wait to complete that task. So in summary, three techniques that you can use. One is in context learning. The second one is using indexing in collaboration with in-context learning. And the third one, and the most difficult one to accomplish, is fine-tuning, which is about rewiring the original model by using your data set. Hopefully, this is helpful for you.